is two doors down from Joey, Kate, and Mary. Their parents died when they were young, and none of them had married. They lived in a shack in the great outback, and life was pretty simple. And each new day we walked to the strings of Joey on the fiddle. Now he'd come down each Sunday morn to sample Mama's cooking. He'd gulp a shot of moonshine down just when she wasn't looking. Sometimes she would catch him, but he'd say it is essential. For aches and pains and more than that, it helps me play the fiddle. So won't you play that fiddle for me, Joey? Won't you play that fiddle one more time? Won't you play that fiddle for me, Joey? 'Cause you sure can play it mighty fine. Now Joey was just 5 feet tall, his face like buckskin leather, and he wore a coat and hot nail boots in every kind of weather. He played all kinds of music, serenading every nation, but mouse would drop when he would stop and play the mason's apron. So won't you play that fiddle for me, Joey? Won't you play that fiddle one more time? Won't you play that fiddle for me, Joey? 'Cause you sure can play it mighty fine. If you go to San Antonio for roses by the dozen, or if you down to Dixie and you fail is out of love, it's two steps up to Tulsa to the other side of town. I'm sure you find old Joey playing Bolum Gavage Down. Then came the day that he would have to go and meet his maker. I hitched a ride the day he died and left his place forever. But sometimes when I dreamed at night, I think when I was little, in the small shack in the great outback with Joey on the fiddle. Won't you play that fiddle for me, Joey? Won't you play that fiddle one more time? Won't you play that fiddle for me, Joey? 'Cause you sure can play it mighty fine. 'Cause you sure can play it mighty fine.
Oh, play it, Joey! Oh, play it, Joey!
The mouse would drop when he would watch a Joey on the fiddle.